Uganda is a landlocked East African country with an enviable deep passion for sports, yet exceptional athletes from all around the country face the same challenge: sports facilities. With no indoor facility to satisfy the basic standards of hosting a continental competition, indoor sports like basketball, volleyball, badminton and table tennis face the greatest problems. Uganda, on the other hand, is taking things to the next level with a projected 15,000-seat arena, a 25-meter-8-lane swimming pool, a malfunctional standard pitch, and a 60-person athlete hotel. Some sporting disciplines, such as cricket, have been left out of the plan when the government of Uganda signed a partnership with the Suma, a tax construction company, to build a state-of-the-art multi-purpose indoor sports complex.
Ideally, we have 4 grass wickets in the country. And if one becomes unavailable for use, it will get to affect so many things right from the local league. So I am sure we'll have an engagement with NCS, but on the good side of it, NCS is already trying to support us to see how we can open up Chambogo ground again for cricket. So that is an engagement that's going on. But I know right now, information is still so limited to give really the kind of comment anyone would want. So I am sure once we get to know what the plans are, how they are to be actioned, we will work with NCS suddenly to have something that is logical so that nothing actually holds.
The great promise of a home for the Uganda Cricket Association was initially made public in February 2013 by the UCA chairman Richard Mwami, who proposed a project to address one of the game's most critical needs, a home. The Cricket Association purchased 14 acres of property in Tsubi, Entebbe, for the construction of a 2 oval practice net, dressing rooms and hotels. Mwami is long gone, and the land in Tsubi, which costs several hundred million dollars, remains dormant, a challenge that the association appears unable to use, neither appear to be interested in.
Our financial position is very healthy, and for facts, we have 800 million put aside for buying land. I believe in structures. If you're to build anything that is sustainable anywhere, you must let the structures work the way they are supposed to work. So we have the land committee that's doing the search for land. Unfortunately, most of the land we've been getting, we get to find it has issues. Either there are a bit of forgeries, families fighting, or when you come to the topology, but something has always been there. But the committee is actually working, and that money is there and it is ready. The moment we get land, it will be paid off and we'll do the developments.
The president of Uganda Badminton Association claims that NCS has not spoken with them about the new plans, which will impact more sports than just cricket.
I know I've seen it on the news. I saw it when the president, HE, the president of Uganda, was meeting with the people who have been given the go ahead to design or develop. We as the sports sector, we haven't really had enough briefing or enough time to digest this. We haven't really gotten any official communication from NCS in terms of what is going to happen, if there are any plans on how we are going to be affected. Of course, for us as an indoor sport, and we have Lugogo, as the CEO has said, we've always been given access. We've never been denied access in Lugogo by NCS. We are very thankful for that. But I would really want to talk from an informed point of view of what they have as a backup plan.
Hello. Where the facility would be built in Lugogo and other specifics, such as when construction will begin and the end, have yet to be addressed. But the proposal now joins a lengthy list of sporting facilities that have been authorized by president but have yet to see the light of the day.
It's been your dream, and more so the people of Uganda, that we put up an infrastructure development plan and we begin to move with the international community. This arena is a blessing, which would be able to accommodate, I think, almost about 15 indoor games. Now, on what happens when the construction work begins, as government, first of all, this infrastructure is government. We are already in constant negotiation with other government entities to house these other indoor games, which will be affected because of the construction works which will take place here. And I want to tell you this, I will get time and be able to inform the country appropriately once we sign a contract with the developer. But we're already working with Makerere University for purpose of completing the indoor games place in Makerere, which will accommodate netball, accommodate even other indoor games within that facility. I have told you of cricket, we're in discussion with the Chambogo University to improve the Chambogo cricket oval for purposes of us moving the cricket oval to Chambogo University. And then other indoor games, we are in talking down with other private owners who have these facilities, this infrastructure to move forward.
Suma, the contractors requested 14 months to set up and build the 15,000 seat arena.